Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you image orthicon in this session. So, image orthicon camera that I'll explain by this session outlines.
So, first I'll explain basics of image orthicon camera. After that, I'll explain diagram of image orthicon camera step by step. And in parallel with that, we will see components of image orthicon camera and working of image orthicon camera. And after that, I'll explain light transfer characteristics of image orthicon camera. And at the end, we'll see some applications which is there with image orthicon camera. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of image orthicon camera. So see, in this image orthicon camera, this tube makes a use of high photo emission sensitivity. So here, this tube that is making a use of high photo emissive sensitivity means here photo emissive sensitivity is higher. So the meaning of higher photo emissive sensitivity is you will be having higher intensity of beam that we provided by having cathode. So if you observe my previous sessions where I have explained Vidicon and Plumbicon, so in that we were been using electron gun and that was emitting electron beam. So here in orthicon camera, that beam emissive power that is way higher than Vidicon and Plumbicon. So this is what we need to take care of. Like it makes a use of higher photo emissive sensitivity. Here image multiplication at target, that we do it by having secondary emission and electron multiplier. So here secondary emission is happening as well as we have electron multiplier at electron beam, right? So that will be multiplying image, means here you will be having better gain. And as it is having better gain, one can say sensitivity is more. So here we have higher sensitivity and here gain of that signal generated by camera is high, and I'll explain you in its working so it will be more clear. And basically we can bisect this image orthicon camera in three sections. One is image section, second is scanning section, and third is electron gun multiplier section. So we will see all three sections in detail so it will be more clear to you like how image orthicon camera is functioning. And one more thing that we need to understand, that is what the name of this camera, that is image orthicon. The meaning of image orthicon is first you will be taking image, again you transfer that image, means you are using that image multiple time and you are mapping that image multiple time. So we have same image and we are having mapping of that image multiple time, and based on that its name is image orthicon. So you will get to know that in working so it will be more clear like how we map that image. So let us have a diagram of it. Now you see we have object that we are delivered to televise, and here we have a lens of camera. So light of this object that is going in this direction and it will enter into the camera. Now this is what a glass structure that we have, and in that glass structure first we will be having photo cathode over here. So here there will be photo cathode and on which we will be falling light of this object. So based on light there will be a generation of electrons on this photo cathode, and density of electron generated on this photo cathode that is purely based on light intensity. Higher the light intensity, higher the density of electron which is generated by this photo cathode. And then this electrons that is having information of image and that information that we are able to transfer over here on this target. Now you see this photocathode that is having voltage which is there around minus 600 voltage. And here we will be moving these electrons on the target which is having lower voltage around minus 3 to minus 5 voltage, and that we even control by having this acceleration anode. So these electrons will get accelerated in this direction by this acceleration anode, and here we have deacceleration anode, and this deacceleration of anode that we do it to increase life of this Orthicon camera. So here we place deacceleration anode, and this deacceleration that we are not doing it for these electrons, this deacceleration that we do it for a beam which is coming from cathode. So I will show you that later. So here acceleration anode that we provide it to have a motion of this electron in this direction, and we have a focusing coil that will focus this electron's motion in this direction. So you can observe these electrons are moving from here to here. See these electrons that is moving from here to here, right? And that we focus it by having focusing coil. Now one can understand this. What we are doing, image was initially detected by this photocathode. Now that image that we transfer it to target over here. And based on this mapping of image, we can say this is what image Orthicon camera. Now here, one more thing that we need to understand. These electrons are getting focused and it is getting traveled in this direction. And that is based on combined action of electrostatic field and longitudinal magnetic field. And that electrostatic field and longitudinal magnetic field that we provide by having focusing coil. So this focusing coil that will focus this electron by providing magnetic and electrostatic force on this electron. And whatever area that is there with this photocathode and the area which is there with this target, then if you observe the area, then area of this target that is almost 3 times compared to the area of this photocathode. So here if you observe the motion of electron, then that motion will be there in conical shape. So that motion of electron that will be there in conical shape. Why? The reason is area of this target is 3 times higher than the area which is there with this photo cathode. So screen area of target is 3 times compared to the area which is there with acceleration anode. So this is about image section. So in image section we detect image by this photocathode and we transfer generated electrons on target, and that density of electron is based on intensity of light, which is what we are following it on this photocathode. Now I'll explain you electron gun with 5-stage electron multiplier. Now see here there are different 5-stage which is there with this electron gun, and that will generate a beam. And you can see this beam that is first moving onto this target, and after reflection again it is getting back to the gun. So what happens here, this beam which is generated from here that will go back to this gun again, and that reflected beam that we are able to receive, and that will be generating output signal. Now that output signal will be very strong. Why that output signal will be very strong? The reason is here this electron gun that is having 5-stage electron multiplier, and those 5 stages will be providing gain around 1000. So this electron gun with 5-stage multiplier provides 1000 gain with the signal which we receive based on this reflection. So this gun will transmit electron beam, and that beam will again come back to this electron gun, and that is what we are receiving as a picture. And how picture is getting generated? So that is based on scanning operation. So let us see scanning operation. Now see, first of all, this electron beam that we are little bit to aligned, so that we do it by having this alignment coil. And here we have deflection coil, where in deflection there are two categories of deflection, horizontal and vertical. Horizontal deflection will do horizontal scanning, and vertical deflection will do vertical scanning. Horizontal deflection is been given with frequency of 15625 hertz, and vertical deflection is been given with frequency of 50 hertz, and that will generate video. And that video signal that we receive it over here, and that is based on reflected beam, and that reflected beam that will be a signal, and that signal will be having higher gain. Why? The reason is there is 5-stage electron gun multiplier. So this complete diagram is bisected into 3 major portion: image section, scanning section, and electron gun multiplier section. Now let us see light transfer characteristics of image Orthicon camera. So as we have seen it for the case of Vidicon and Plumbicon, on x axis there is luminance, and on y axis there is output current in terms of microampere. Now if you observe the characteristic which I have made it for a comparison of two different cases, so here you have two tubes, one is tube A and one is tube B. For tube A we can say slope is less, and for tube B we can say slope is more. And here you will be observing these are the parallel lines. It doesn't mean slopes are same. Why? The reason is this graph is logarithmic graph. So in that, if you calculate this change in y by change in x, then we'll be finding, like, see, for the case of this tube A, this change in y, that is almost 10, divided by change in x, that is even 10. So 10 by 10, 1 microampere per candela. While for tube B, change in y, that is 10, and change in x, that is 1. So 10 by 1, that is 10. So we can say slope of tube B, that is higher than slope of tube A. So obviously based on that, what we can say, tube B is having higher sensitivity than tube A. But we need to understand what is tube A and tube B. So see, tube A, that is there for very close target spacing. So you have seen that target, and if you have tube A with very close target spacing, then it will be having good SNR with the cost of sensitivity and contrast ratio. So sensitivity, that is based on slope, so that is what less for tube A, right? So we can say tube A, that is for close target distance, and in that SNR will be good at the cost of sensitivity and contrast ratio. While in case of tube B, you'll be finding there will be wider spacing for target, and that will be improving sensitivity and contrast ratio. So this is what about light transfer characteristic, where tube B, that is having higher sensitivity, and that is having higher sensitivity because of wider spacing, while tube A, that is having lower sensitivity, and that is having lower span sensitivity because of it is having close spacing for a target. And based on higher and lower spacing, there are applications. So for tube A, we can use that for primarily, we use it for outdoor pickups, while we use tube B for studio, and it requires strong illumination. So this is all about image.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel, so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.